Welcome back to Channel Fireball. I'm your host, Patrick Marlette of the 99, and this is part two of our Commander Legends gameplay. So if you haven't seen the draft, I'll encourage you to watch that first because it was excellent.
Hey, it's Rebel. Again, you might have seen me on YouTube or like Instagram. I'm here.
I'm Pete. I'm back for more bloodshed.
Hey, I'm Phil. Come check out our Instagram, ramp_gang.
All right, guys, I hope you're ready for this. We've drawn our hands. We are seeing who's going first. That person's me. Take a good look. It's going to be great. Ooh, Gormaldrak is ready to drop some sallies.
Amphinobologist.
I will play a Forestes per turn. And guess what? I'm going to do this the right way. First, you announce the spell you're casting. I'm casting Fine Horn Elves. Take a look at those girls. I'll use a forest.
To pay for casting your spell.
Correct. Nice. And I am going to pass with that sweet, sweet turn.
I'm glad you could find Horn Elves.
I'm going to play a forest.
Wait a minute. Why are we going that way?
Oh.
Yeah!
Judge!
Alright, I think that just makes this a three-person game.
Right? Yeah,
did you just horrify yourself?
I don't want to play this game.
Set Rebel's deck on fire.
I think when we rolled, you had the higher roll.
No, because you said he was going last.
Oh, no.
He didn't want me to go last,
okay.
Because in a game that wasn't on the camera, I went first a bunch of times.
Please, take your turn.
I'll go second.
Sir.
Well, bam! We're going to play a schwamp.
Okay.
That's it.
Oh, interesting.
Well, it seems like a good reason.
DFT, I will play an island.
Okay.
And okay. I will also tap that island.
Whoa!
To preordain.
Oh,
right. Very good, very good. I'll be scrying too.
He does it the opposite way. Mm-hmm. Does it ever bother anyone else when someone taps their mana before casting the spell? Is it just me?
No, I kind of like what you did.
Yeah, you're kind of weird like that.
But it is weird.
But that's the way to do it.
We'll keep those both on top.
Pass
the turn.
Okay.
Did you draw the card?
Oh, and I will draw this card for the preordained.
You know, the rest of the text.
I will complete.
He stopped to describe.
Preordained would be a terrible
card.
It's
so good.
Ooh,
the scribe is so juicy.
I'll pass.
Really? No, find one else.
No, because someone drafted them.
It wasn't exclusively me. I'll play another Forestes. I'm a Simiclist. And I'll go ahead and play a Gift of Paradise, and I'll pay for that by tapping here, here, and here. But I do need to choose my target first for this aura. Which forest looks better?
I think this one. Yeah.
Right. Oh my god, yeah. Yes!
Yeah. Unanimous.
Right? I don't know. Did you? Comment section down below. Which forest would you have chosen? Pete's?
I think the other.
Or everyone else's? Are you a lemming?
Personal.
Or are you an original? Okay, I'm gonna play Gift of Paradise, and if you guys don't know what it does, don't worry about it. I gain life.
Mm-hmm. And gives you manazes.
Yes, so just the trigger
for
now.
It doesn't ramp.
It does not technically ramp, but it will ramp this next turn.
Color fixes. What doesn't Enchanted Land
have? Two of any one color.
A two of any one color.
Could you imagine?
That's way
could you imagine if it just gave life and gave
and color fixing? I was like, that card's terrible.
It ramps. It doesn't ramp now.
That's not a game.
Pass safe and
slow.
Hoopa! We are gonna play.
It's pretty decent ramp.
Another swamp. Pass turn.
Oh, really interesting play.
Some seriously exciting DFT. Goings on here.
Do you have your Gift of Paradise?
No.
I just want to be. I want you to join the club.
I
want
to join the club too.
I've got two salamanders in paradise.
Time for a mountain. It's time to announce Captain Vargas Wrath.
Who's Captain Vargas Wrath?
The most broken legendary.
An orc pirate.
Can you read the flavor in your best?
To be a successful cutthroat, you have to truly enjoy the work.
That's capitalism.
So I just need to read this card again. So when he attacks, pirates get bigger. For each time you've cast a commander from the command zone. Wow. Threatening.
Okay.
Zero times thus far.
So +0/+0. Got it. Keep those dice handy though.
Yep.
Yeah, we're gonna have to track that.
Is that a big passe vu for you?
That's a big passe vu. Go ahead, Rebel.
I'll play a plains and then drop my first diamond. Marble diamond.
Yeah, that's like the Swarovski in the world of MTG.
It's quartz, yeah.
Yeah, like the girlfriend will appreciate it, but she's still hoping for the diamond.
For the Mox diamond.
She's still hoping for the Mox diamond.
Yeah, that's a promise ring.
Ooh. That's a Glotta. All right, I'm going to play another Forestes because that's all I got. Then we're going to drop, let's see, I've got one, two, three, four, 5 mana. Ramp is king. And I'll show you why. Because this guy's looking to murder me or something. I'm nervous about it. Why? I'll show you why. Let's just start with an Elvish Visionary. Visions are scary.
Are you rapping or?
I was trying to. I started and I stopped.
I wasn't. Yeah.
No, it's okay.
I wasn't judging.
Should I next time? I'll.
Yeah.
Next
yeah, just
time.
An 100%.
Okay.
Yeah, that's main phase. Main
phase rapping. Draw a card.
Part of the.
Does anyone want to do anything while the draw's on the stack?
No, it resolves.
Are you certain?
The draw resolves.
You have no idea what you just allowed. You all.
We're done.
Basically.
Wow. You should have.
T Rex scoop up my cards.
You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and play my commander. I'll be the first. Gormaldrek!
At the beginning of your end step.
So I'm gonna go ahead and generate 2 blue off of my Gift of Paradise. Thank you, Paradise. And I'm gonna tap them sweet, sweet Finehorn Owls. Take a look at those girls. And cast Gord. So at the, yes, correct. At the beginning of my end step, I'm not there yet. It's only in phase one.
Okay.
I get to create a little salamander, and we, of all the tokens we drafted, didn't manage to get a salamander. So I think nearest thing might be a prismatic piper. Yeah, so at the beginning
Smanders.
Of your end step, each player who controls the fewest creatures creates a blue salamander warrior creature token. So we just need to bear in mind that these are 4/3 bodies. If you'd like, you can just put a 4 down.
Yeah.
A 4 down.
That makes sense.
And let the chaos begin. Enjoy.
What sound do salamanders
enjoy,
make?
Boys and girl?
Like, meh. That's like a horse.
I think that's
like
it. A seahorse underwater would be like.
But like a salamander. Like, what did salamanders. Are they like.
Comment in the comment section down below.
Oh. Onomatopoeia, your sound.
And I pass.
I'm actually going to play a card this turn.
Oh, that's good.
It's an island. No, I'm actually going to play more. All right, we're going to play Armix Filigree Thrasher.
What does Armix do?
Whenever Armix Filigree Thrasher attacks, I can discard a card. And when I do, a creature defending player controls gets -X/-X, where X is the number of artifacts you control plus the number of artifact cards in your graveyard.
I have listened. Just...
Thrasher's gonna don't worry. Everything's gonna be fine. Everything's gonna be fine.
Just have me a Filigree Thrasher.
Let me know when I'm dead.
Filigree Thrasher, guys.
Let me know when I'm dead.
You're passing?
Time.
I'm not attacking with
you
my
salamander. You have a salamander.
He's on defense, bro.
Salamander's on D.
Once you've given me the salamander, it's my salamander.
Oh,
I control it and get to do what I
pressure
want.
Pressure him.
Okay, don't get carried
do
away.
Things with
I'm the amphenologist, okay? I'm just studying your board. And yeah. It looks like that salamander.
He's ripe for attack.
Could have done more. No, I was kidding.
You pass to me?
Yes.
I've untapped.
Okay.
I'm going to DFT. Just draw for turn.
I've been wondering what that means. I've been playing a lot of video games in that phrase.
I'm AFK right now.
AFK, DFT.
Yeah. I'm playing.
Gonna do some DMT later.
Poor turn.
No,
yeah, that's
don't
great.
Do DMT.
Taxes?
One, two. DMT.
All right.
Oh.
Going to also Sky Diamond.
Ooh.
Weep.
Enters play.
Big cheese. Big cheese.
With the Sky Diamond. It was on the stack when he played.
So
actually, yeah, it hadn't actually resolved.
That's fair.
Now it's resolved and it's tapped, and I will again. Preordinate.
Okay.
And toss that directly.
Preordination.
Into my,
okay.
I will allow you to begin your turn shortly.
Top, don't draw.
Bottom and top, and then draw.
Okay.
Thank you.
Interesting.
You may go.
Interesting. I don't trust those lilac sleeves.
No.
You're playing with Pete.
So gentle.
You couldn't go with a more.
So gentle.
You couldn't go
gentle.
With a more.
But they're purple
tone.
Because the deck is purple.
That's right. Is it?
Red and blue.
It
is.
Is it?
It
is.
Isn't it?
Yes.
Ain't it?
Uh-oh. What's Rebel up to over
Rebel,
there?
Rebel, take your time.
I have to thinkies.
What are they doing?
The
thinky pains.
Thinkies. Yeah.
I didn't know he read each player. I'm not gonna lie to you.
It's gonna be salamanderific today.
It will. Well, it actually,
Piper.
Right now, you two are tied.
That's true.
I have so many creatures.
Yeah, it's not you. It's never going to be you.
I built this deck wrong.
For us, it's for us.
Yeah, group hug.
Sisse's ring.
Salamander group hug. That art, by the way, is among one of the better arts in the set.
I have one of them, actually. You see?
Awesome.
I've got a ring just like it.
I should have one.
You do too. You also.
You passing?
Yeah, I'm passing.
Okay. I think at the end of your turn, I'll do nothing. I'll take my ring.
You're going to.
Is that okay?
I'm gonna play a 0 mana instant.
Let's go ahead, draw per turn, DTF. always hitting the forest. Always hitting the forest when I need it. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 manas on deck. And no one is doing anything.
All right, Grapple Stillskin.
Let's just see what I can do with this.
You ready for some salamanders, dog?
I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna float a grain. I'm gonna show you a variation of how you can cast a spell, kids. Then I'll go to cast 3 visits, right? And to pay off the remainder, I'll tap this forest. Mm. How about that?
How complicated.
Okay, so discard out.
It resolves. I wish I could get an island.
After with this. You.
Where do elves go to relieve themselves? The forest room.
Which one? The 4 restrooms?
Yes. The 4, all 4 of them.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, wow, you took that joke a different way.
Elves have multiple...
trees. This is high quality content.
Thanks for joining. Yeah. Elves are such nomadic
little... I mean, does an elf poop in the woods? I don't know.
Not if you don't hear it.
Does a hate bear poop in the woods?
does a hate bear poop in the woods?
Dude, I know
does
that.
Does a salamander poop in the woods? Probably not, actually.
No.
Probably the water.
Probably revisits the water. Yeah. It's a natural habitat before it, you know, grew legs and everything. I am thinking that I am going to drop something similar to this card. And that is, nope, I can't even cast that. I don't have the mana. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have to cast this card. We're going to cast a Nevenroll's Disc.
Mm. And Nevenroll saw that coming.
Nevern and y'all got nothing for that?
Nope. Not zero. That, sir, enters the battlefield tap.
It's on the stack. Mm-hmm. Does it resolve?
It No. Yes.
Was Force of Will printed in this set? Unfortunately not. So, yeah, Nev's Disc going to enter tapped. I'm okay with the board state right now. I'm going to go ahead and swing along a ding-dong at the only person who can't block me.
You impermanence you control.
Oh yes.
Have protection.
Oh yes, take 3.
Gotta move the game along, you know? I'm just, we gotta record commander
yeah,
damage.
Yeah, it's commander damage. Yeah.
Oh yes, so I'm gonna choose the most salamander-like counter, and that would be a star.
Definitely.
Do you imagine? Okay. And with that, I think I'm happy to pass the turn.
Okay.
Are you creating salamanders?
Oh, I'm so sorry. You have 2 creatures. You have 1 creature. You have 1 creature. Please be my salamander.
Everybody gets a salamander.
Except
yes.
Except for me.
Salamander.
Everybody gets a salamander.
Does this work for everyone? The soldier salamander?
Can you flip it over? That way we'll know that all the face-down magic cards are like...
are stupid guys.
Until you use the double side.
Got him.
I got you.
There you go.
Yep, all I got is double side.
I need that token back.
Oh, okay.
End play an is land.
Does that scare you? Does that scare you?
I'll block.
I'll double block. Because I want to make salamanders. I'm doing this wrong. I will double block. I'm totally doing this wrong. These should be for me.
So you can lose creatures so that you can
just make salamanders.
And then try to get rid of them.
I had one goal in mind.
You try to always like reach an equilibrium of less salamanders than everyone. That's the strategy.
Yeah. I need to self-sacrifice.
And then
Nevenroll. Yes.
And then just disc it. Wipe the board.
Gotta disc it for the biscuit.
I kind of imagine he's like a guy who keeps goofing up. Just like lets out on these salamanders.
Yeah. Yeah, they're like in little cages.
He's got his little jam jar.
It overfloweth with manders.
What are you thinking?
So silly.
So, I'm gonna play a Seer's Lantern, which is a land, basically.
But counts for
a scrying boy.
Just remember that for your dockside total. Another card I wish I was reprinted.
And then,
actually, not really.
I'm going to attack Mr. Patrick. Trigger. When I attack, I can discard a card to it, and a creature on defending player's side gets -X-X, where X is the number of artifacts that I have in play, which is currently 2.
You can kill
or the graveyard.
You can kill. Do you see the graveyard? Go for it.
We're gonna actually take the elves.
Both of them.
No, just the
just
one.
One.
Just
one.
The one.
You only target one thing.
Yep. So I'm gonna give that -2/-2 by discarding a Nadir's Nightblade. Blockage?
I'll take three.
And that's commander damage.
Oh yes, we've got 2 tickets.
Can we go with the little skull? Because he's, you know,
Like a
Phyrexian, basically.
For you?
Sure.
Appreciate that. Does everyone, is everyone tied often for creature count?
Two.
Does everyone Mander?
Everyone gets a Mander. I'm gonna end this game quick.
Are we Mandering?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. Patrick also controls the disc, which, you know, makes...
Dictates the Mander allocation.
You're a Disc-tator.
Yes. In fact.
Wait, is it at the end of every turn?
At the end of Patrick's
turn. Okay. Oh my. I was really
could you imagine?
Okay. I was going to say,
what is this?
The salamanders reproduce at an alarming rate.
We can't stop them.
Too alarming.
It's right. Mander getting.
Mander Geddon.
I am Mountain. I believe.
Why did we all do that?
I don't know. I think the move here is to bring in Elena, Kessing Trapper.
That's the move.
Okay.
She strikes first.
She taps to add an amount of mountain mana equal to the greatest power among creatures you control.
Mountain
into the back
mana.
This turn.
Mountain mana.
And I will pass.
Let's draw some Mander blood.
Ooh!
I'll swing this one over at Phillies.
Ooh!
And I'll swing this over to. He has first strike.
She's the Salamander Slayer.
Do it anyways.
Spice. Both at Phil.
Whoa.
It's personal.
I will block a Mander. With
a Mander?
Mander on Mander
violence. Mander on Mander violence. That's actually like the biggest problem with this commander.
Flavor.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's the flavor.
It's a little disgusting.
Flavor. It's a yeah. It's a salty.
Pretty cruel.
You take
salty. I take four.
Flavor.
One.
Wait, one, two.
It's a brackish tint.
Yes. A brackish
one,
tint.
Two, three, four, five, six. I'm gonna cast.
No, cut that one.
Okay.
There's a new king on the.
It's a big boy.
Don't worry.
There's a big boy. Don't worry about it. The Kadama Mama. Don't have a way to destroy it.
You do.
I'll take.
You literally have never rolls.
Oh, I'm not going to activate it when I'm making mana. I'm going to go ahead and untap Gore Muldrak and his army of one. And I'll go drop per turn. We will cast the Fertilin.
Seems good.
So Fertilin, two generic, one green, enters with two 1/1 counters. And I can remove +1/+1 counters to make target players search their library for a basic land and put on the battlefield tapped. I think the best thing we can do, if I'm being honest with you, is swing Mr. Gore. Muldrak, your way.
Beep, boop, bop.
How do we do that?
Star. Oh no!
It's a star. You're gonna sweat down.
Yeah, sweat down. Yeah.
And it can go to counters.
Oh, I see.
There
I see.
Go. And then
boom.
Hit the star.
Boom, technology.
That's right.
One, two. What was I at before?
That looks accurate.
Sure.
Yeah.
I probably messed that up in a middle lower life.
I think
okay.
That I'm going to go ahead with that and pass a boot. But at the end, you get
oh, yes, I do. I get
you a
Mander. Mander.
Yeah, just you. Enjoy that.
Thank you.
Yeah, of course.
The Great Mander Equalizer.
Yes.
It's basically balance.
Play a Schwamp.
I just want to see some more artifacts and enchantments hit the field.
Sure.
I will cast a Staunch Throne Guard.
Oh, there's another artifact.
I
staunch
become the monarch.
Okay.
I am the king.
Oh, there should be a little crowd.
Any man who says that they are the king is no king.
No king of mine.
Elvis?
Joffrey.
Oh, Elvis,
from
though.
Lord of the Rings?
Rebel?
Isn't that Star Wars?
Rebel? I'll enter my end step and draw a card from being the monarch.
Indeed. Immediately following
which
that.
Is pretty great.
Is my untap phase. And a draw.
Need a flyer to get in there. Take the crown. And or just crack this
don't
disc.
We.
Crack the disc. Crack the disc, bro.
Play another.
Kind of just waiting for the disc to go. Frodo, destroy it!
Destroy the disc!
Cast the disc into the fire!
Let me just hold it for a moment.
No, it's mine. My own.
I'm going
my
to
precious.
A merchant raider's.
Oh, treasures for you!
I have treasures.
Oh no, this is a much, much scarier card.
Yeah, this is kind of
crazy. Oh yeah, I don't like this card.
Can we do the treasures instead?
Well, it taps things.
You play another pirate, then it will tap a creature and that creature will not untap for as long as this creature remains on the battlefield.
Every time a pirate ETBs. It does happen
it
right
now. It starts
now.
Yes. Oh wow, okay.
ETBs, the thing is.
Steal the crown.
I don't really know what I'm gonna do. I think I'm gonna steal the crown.
Take the crown.
Don't hit me.
You're a pirate, that's what pirates do.
Yeah.
It's on
brand. It's on brand.
Treasure
on brand.
Thing. It's gold, shiny.
Yeah, this guy's a 2/5. I think I'm going to tap down your staunch throne beast.
Mm. Okay.
And then I do believe I'm going to come at you, bro. I hate to do it.
If I double block here, your commander dies. Oh, and true, only true, one true. Of my creatures dies.
True, true, true.
We don't deal with attack.
We don't deal with terrorists!
I think what we're actually going to do... I think that I'm going to just mander at you, Phil. And that's all.
That's all she wrote?
Just a single mander attacking at you.
I will not block the mander.
That's okay. All that slithered.
That's fine.
You're the king.
And I interesting. Will then add an amount of red mana equal to the greatest power among creatures that entered the battlefield this turn. Equal to 2, because I've cast a Merchant Raiders. So I've got 2 floating.
Okay.
I will use that 2 blue to cast Malcolm, Keen-Eyed Navigator. 2/2 flying, whenever one or more pirates you control deal damage to your opponents, you create a treasure token for each opponent dealt damage.
What are you tapping?
That is the question. I think we need to start tapping down Kodama.
Oof.
That's fair.
Yeah.
It is fair.
Okay.
Because it reaches Malcolm. He's not out of its grasp. Not
that
yet.
Is all that I will do.
Snatch Malcolm out of the sky.
I want treasure.
But this Mander untaps.
Oh, yes.
Jeez. She's untapping.
Just untapping.
Oh!
Mander. That's Mander damage.
That is Mander.
When you're at 26?
Mm-hmm.
Never mind, I'll go this way.
Right. Ooh, yeah. That's Mander damage.
4?
4.
You trying to be some monarchs? You trying to be some monarchs?
Oh, yeah. You should think about that monarchy.
Oh, he's a...
I let it
yeah.
in.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh,
yeah. Yeah, you're coming at me, right?
Yeah, yeah. Sure. I planned that.
Triple
yeah,
block.
Yeah, totes.
Triple block.
I relinquish the monarchy to you and take 4 damage.
Dang.
I
look at that.
To my end step.
Who would have known? It's so easy to become monarch. Okay. I'm going to make double green, and we're going to go ahead and grab a land. I'm targeting myself for this. Does anyone care?
I care, but I can't do anything.
I also care.
First island.
Congratulations.
Simic list.
Now you can blow up the disc and still have blue.
I know, I was worried about that. It comes into play tapped, rather. Anyway, that's all I'm gonna do at the end of your turn. Does anyone have any other actions?
All good.
Oh, cool. Mm-hmm. All right, after this shuffle, let's go ahead and untap Evu. Let's go ahead and cast, to begin with, a Prophetic Prism. Mm-hmm. Ooh, that's a card. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, we're gonna go ahead and move to combat. I'll swing Gore Muldrak at you, Rebel.
I'll take it personally.
I bet you will. I'm also gonna... Sorry, I should do this first. I'll also send the Fertilizer away. You can take it extra personally. Blink.
Never coming back.
Wow, Fertilid getting in there.
Crown smells good. Fertilid Crown smells real teeth. Good. The best thing to do would be to pass. And I'll draw.
I so you don't want to sack the Fertilid and get a Mander yourself? I don't know.
Okay. No, it's okay.
Fine. Mm.
He's... disc.
Kodama trigger, nothing. Keep going.
Draw. I figure a Mander for you is just as good as a Mander for me.
A Mander in the bush.
Is worth
two in the
bush. Hen.
Two in the Mander.
And two in the dog.
In the man zone.
Alright. I will attack Patrick with Urmix. Trigger. Discard island to nug your Elvish Visionary.
Elvish Visionary, you say?
A likely target.
All right, and you're swinging with a 3/2 at me? That's fine, I'll take 3. Unless you have a way to buff it or anything
nope.
crazy?
You're okay. good.
Weep.
I'll play the Malfield Twins. It's a 4/4, when it dies, create 2 zombie creature tokens.
That's really not bad.
I pass my turn.
I will cast a Prosperous Pirate.
Yar.
Is this the booty receiving?
He receives the booty.
How much?
2 booty.
2 booty. Do you want to use a die, or do you want me to give you 2 whole booty?
This looks fine.
Okay.
And I will
like be some more.
No, actually, no. I've got one here. Here's a couple of booties.
With a Malcolm.
Yeah, this is...
All right. And we've cast a pirate, so we have a trigger here. Mm-hmm. Merchant Raiders will tap somebody indefinitely. Mm. I'm liking your Malfist twins. Your Malfeld.
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 Malfeld twins.
Oh, I get it. They're like, it's like a double-headed zombie, and when it dies, it splits in half.
Mm-hmm.
That flavor.
Yeah?
Thanks, Kevin.
It says, who am I to break up a family?
That flavor. Yeah, I believe he's the target. I will tap him indefinitely. Enter combat.
Okay.
I don't see any flyers. I will swing Malcolm at you, Rebel.
Ow.
And then I will level an Elena at you, Patrick.
Elena at me?
Mm-hmm.
I'll take it.
Alright. So in the order of operations, damage will be assigned there first, and then 4 to you, sir. That is commander damage, yes?
So you get 1 treasure.
I will threaten to cast a Court of Aya. By tapping this, popping 2 treasure.
3 treasure.
3 treasure, and tapping my Sky Diamond for 5.
Mana open? Mana open?
0.
Okay. Yeah, we do need to respond to that. I'm gonna go ahead and cast Supreme Will, targeting the Court of Ire, and it's 1 blue, so I'll tap this 1 island here and the 2 for Restes. So you have to pay 3 to...
I do not have it.
Yep.
This is good for everyone, except for me.
I think so.
You're welcome.
Yeah. That's all I want to do. All
right.
Okay.
Does not resolve. I do not have
it. Geez, your turn.
Enter combat. Mm-hmm. 2 Manders this way.
I'll block 1.
Yep.
And you receive the monarchy once again, Rebel.
Indeed.
Congratulations on your crown.
I'll play a silverback shaman.
A 5/4.
Wow. 5/4. When it dies, I draw a card.
Yeah, all right.
That's pretty good stuff.
Then value boy.
Kodama trigger. I'm going to put in a commander sphere.
Oof.
And then I will pass.
That's really good. Oof. It's a bit of a busted ability.
Yeah. I'm trying to think if I want to do anything at the end of your turn. So I'll go ahead. Remove a counter, and I'll target myself to grab a land.
Sure.
Okay, that's draw for turn. I will start by casting the Sifter Worm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7?
Mm-hmm.
7.
What's his ETB?
So Sifter Worm is a 7/7 trample worm. When Sifter Worm enters the battlefield, scry 3, then reveal the top card of your library. You gain life equal to the card's converted mana cost. Okay, ooh, this is... okay, wow, that was interesting. And then reveal the top card of your library. It is a runaway together. And yeah, I gain life. Look at that. Can't recover from the unfortunate commander damage. But I'll go ahead and cast an Aqueous Form targeting the Sifter Horn.
Did you...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... 8.
I'm just checking to see that you tapped out with the disc on the board.
I did.
Okay.
You're good to go. I'm not looking to use the nav disc now. I think
we're all wondering.
We want to swing along a ding-dong this way and put you at 6 commander damage. And at the end of this turn, that's been so long, I'm going to make my own little salamander.
Hmm.
And with that, I'll go ahead and pass a vu.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, on my upkeep, I will scry 1 with the Seer's Lantern. Hmm. All right, we're gonna put that on the bottom.
What was scryed? Ooh.
Pirate don't care.
And
to play or not to play more creatures? That is the question.
With a nev.
Whether it is nobler to die by the salamander or via the commander damage. Stricken to thee.
Stricken to thee. 1, 2, 3. I'll play a Spectral Searchlight.
Okay.
And then...
Huh. Is that for me?
I think so. I think it's gonna be 2.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3.
Oh, you choose yourself?
Yeah.
I choose me.
Yeah.
Greedy.
I choose me!
The spirit of the holidays.
But no. Give the gift of disc.
And then I'll play a Filigree Familiar and gain 2 life. Because I need to, because everyone's punching me.
Seems fair.
And I'm gonna not go for the Monarch.
Interesting.
Because I'm tired of being punched.
Mm.
And then pass.
Valid. It was a valid turn.
Twas a turn.
With
he
a
took.
Nev's disc in play. Interesting.
How interesting?
Not very, it turns out.
Elaborate.
I've read the card, and the card explains the card, making it worse. I will begin to consider entering combat.
Okay.
I've considered it, and I've entered combat.
Excellent.
I don't blame you.
There's some open manners, but what can a pirate say? The pirate comes in at you, Rebel, and then Amander goes towards Phil, and Elena goes
also towards Phil.
Most contemplative attack.
Kay. And also a prosperous pirate enters combat towards Phil.
Jeez.
Why are you coming to me, man? Yeah, I feel that I need to squeak out some combat because Nev is so primed. So I'm going to really try to get the most out of
this. This was the safe
pile rats. That is all for my attackers. I have declared all of them attacking.
I'll block the Mander with my 3 power guy and the 4 power guy with my Filigree Familiar. And I will take 3.
Mm-hmm. Draw a card.
I'll draw a card from the Familiar. Mm-hmm. These die. This goes here. This goes here. This has been cast once.
You get a trigger for the pirate, Malcolm.
Yep.
Over here?
Yep. I will create a treasure. Okay. Having dealt damage, and that is commander damage. Thank you.
And monarchy.
Monarchy becomes my very own.
So you have Malcolm damage. Oh, cool.
She's got it. And let us.
She's got it.
pass the turn. It's a lot of open manners.
A lot of open manners.
What we're doing.
draw for the monarchy?
Oh, yeah, let's draw. That's not before you do that. Again. Who stands to Mander? You stand to Mander, I feel.
He stands to Mander.
At this point, we'll see.
And then I will attack with the gorilla. I'm kidding.
I mean, that is open.
And Mander.
Now I'm ass in the wind here.
Bunch of
the crown.
It's a pretty chill number. 9. I take a chill 9. I give you a monarchy. It's a cool 9.
And then I will
pass. It's a sick 9, bruh. It's a sick 9. Mm-hmm. Get the discard?
Yep. Unless you got instants.
I'll discard this Keleth. Sun main familiar.
Oh, that's the buffer of commanders?
Yeah.
Gotcha.
I pass. My commander's not attacking.
Interesting. So I will untap with a completely safe Gort Maldrak. And we know it's on top. I'll go ahead and grab that. Let's run away together. Try to make this pirate plays. This is a really weird turn.
These pirate plays?
Pirate plays. Try to make them pirate plays!
Yeah, that's the correct play always.
It seems as much. I think what I'm going to do, enter Wombat. Okay, and I'm gonna go ahead and swing along a ding dong with the Sifter Worm. The Sifter Worm is actually gonna go your way, Pete. Then
I'm vulnerable.
I think that we're gonna do this poor little Mander this way, and I'll also go ahead and send Gor Maldrak your way. So that's 7 at you, Pete. This is 4 at you.
Liberal.
This is 3 at you. I'll take the monarchy. But also when we do the attack, so before any of that really, I'm just gonna go ahead and scry. I know it's on top. I'm gonna ship it to the bottom. So what we're gonna do is cast for 1, 2. I'll cast Runaway Together, and I'm gonna go ahead and bounce this. I know, weird. And I'm gonna bounce this Mander right here.
Sure.
Okay.
He did.
So I have 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2.
3. I have 3 creatures.
3. Oh. This one.
Okay.
This one.
Keep it.
I'm sorry. I didn't realize that these were creatures.
I'll keep my man.
So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 creatures. You have 1, 2 creatures. You have 1, 2 creatures. You have 1, 2 creatures. Okay, so bounce to your hand, which means nowhere. Beginning of my end step, we're all going to make Manders.
Except for me.
ATP trigger.
Sorry about that.
I'm gonna put it in.
Cool. I'm gonna go ahead and please grab some dice.
So nice.
Before cleanup here, I'm gonna go ahead and cast Sweet Gum Recluse.
No.
So for 1, 2, that's gonna be blue, why not?
Cascade.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay.
What does that sweet gum do?
It has flash, cascade, reach, and then when Sweet Gum Recluse enters the battlefield, put 3 +1/+1 counters on each of any number of target creatures that enter the battlefield this turn. So, I suppose I should resolve the cascade first?
I think you shuffle them
so.
At the bottom.
You shuffle them and put them down, yeah.
Oh.
All right.
Okay, cool. Okay. So I get to cast this Army of Ioris. And for the trigger, yes, you're gonna get +3/+3, you're gonna get +3/+3, you're gonna get +3/+3, and you're gonna get +3/+3.
So there's 7 6
putting up here.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Yes. Which I'm immune to.
Wow. Yeah, you're really all about making Manders.
And I'll go ahead and draw for the monarchy at the end of my turn before passing. Okay.
Okay. Cool. On my upkeep, I will scry one. Not what we were looking for. Also not what we were looking for. Put a swamp into play. Three. We'll play the Ghost of Ramirez DiPietro. And then I will also play this commander, which is not a commander, but it's in my 99, which is a 2/2 that says commanders I control have menace and death touch. That'll do.
That'll do.
That'll do. That's my turn.
That'll do, little nightmare cat. That'll do.
It's not a pirate, but it is an omen speaker.
Which we all know.
She has entered the battlefield. Everyone is okay with her resolving. Mm-hmm. Seems mm-hmm. fine.
Sure. She scries.
Right here.
Yep. Okay. That's sweet gum.
In the bottom.
Cool card. It really is. It really is. I don't know if it was passed to me or if I...
I'll bottom that.
Did you pass it to me?
Probably.
You were on the black.
Yeah, I wasn't really looking at the green cards at that point.
I don't blame you.
Pat's flipping out. He's got
a... I do have a Reacher. Just
have a
FYI.
Reacher.
Yeah.
I think we need to work together on this one.
But not on me attacking you.
But not with your Manders.
Not with the Manders.
Your Commanders, maybe.
Pat's at 35.
Yeah.
Got the disc.
Got the disc.
Got the disc. I've got the power.
I'm going to force him to use the disc at some point.
You're willing to?
Yeah. I've been on team hoping for the disc for a little while now.
Team hoping for the disc.
I'm okay without it.
You've got a single Mander.
Super precautionary.
7-6.
Super precautionary.
That's a 7-6.
All right, I think we're only going to get in with Malcolm, and that is going to be leveled at you, Rebel. And I will create a treasure. Enter main phase 2. I am going to cast Fall from Favor, targeting
the sweet gum. What does Fall from Favor do?
I will cast it, and as it enters the battlefield, I'll tap Enchanted Creature, and I will become the Monarch. Enchanted Creature doesn't untap during its controller's untap step unless that player is the Monarch.
Like it. I'll trade.
I will, in fact, become the Monarch, go to the end of my turn, draw for Monarch, and pass.
Okay, so then after the stack is clear green, white, I'll play Benevolent Blessing on, this one, the Mander.
The big Mander.
Protection from blue. ETB Trigger Kodama, I'm gonna put in Livio.
You can do the same mana cost?
Yes.
Sweet gum. Yes.
The sweetest of gums.
Sweet gum.
I'll exile that. Remove this vault from favor.
Actually, I will exile my Kodama.
Okay.
Yes, I understand.
And then my turn. Attack. Play planes.
Here's an Aegis counter.
Oh, yes. The counter of the ages.
I'm gonna swing the salamander. I can't swing a hand, so.
Ooh!
Try and take the monarch.
The Mander is blue, right?
Mander is a 7-6.
No, but what color is
Owie
it?
Owie Zowie.
The only thing he can block with is Elena.
Yeah, understood.
Pressure.
Does Elena bite the salamander's bullet?
It's a 7-6. I'm going to cast a Welding Sparks by popping one of these boys for a red. 2/3, and I will deal 5 to your Mander. And then, is that cool? Is that chill? Okay. And then I will block with Elena. Killing him soundly. Killing the Mander soundly.
Poor Mander.
Sorry, bub.
It really is heartbreaking.
She serve, she protect. Elena.
I'll tap 3.
Save the treasure.
I'll bring back the Kodama.
Interesting.
Untapped. And then I'll tap.
That's two, good.
Tap 5, 6, 7. I'll bring in a Chroma. And then trigger, I will.
7 or less?
7 or less.
Trigger. And then she'll get plus 1, 2, 3, 4.
She's 10-10.
So she'll be a 10-10.
She's a 10-10. That's really not bad.
Jeepers.
Creepers.
I'll bring in a Sisse's Ring. Sisse's Ring into a Moss Diamond.
Nice.
Sisse's Ring trigger. Spectral Searchlight. And then I will cast the Mox.
Right, yes, that makes sense. Again.
Very nice.
Yeah, wow.
Go ahead.
Look at all those artifacts. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and untap
here. Rock salad over there.
You're.
That's a reference. It's a never-ending story.
Is it?
Kind of. Not really.
I'll go ahead and DTF.
DFT.
I mean, he's DTF, so.
Draw the freaking card. Draw the card.
He's down to fight.
You know me, I'm DTF. I'm gonna go ahead and start by playing a Forestes. Alright, that seems fair. Then I'll tap two of these Forestes to move to equip the Armory of Ioris. Ioris? We're gonna put this on, I think, potentially my commander or this worm. Because the bigger the worm,
the harder they fall.
Big unblockable worm.
So yeah, we'll do that. Right? Yeah, it's targetable. Put that on the worm. Let me see here. What else should I do on my turn? I wonder.
How big that worm?
The worm?
The worm?
You want to know how big my worm is? He's about to be 8-8, my friend.
Right, 8 there. Unblockable?
So on the attack, yes. So
it's pretty deep.
8 unblockable trample, a little redundant. and that's it. So on the it's attack, labor. Though, I get the +1/+1. So it's an 8-8 flying at you. I don't think we're going to swing anything else. Thank you for the monarchy.
You have monarched.
I have monarched. Let's go ahead and cast a Armorcraft Judge. So when it enters the battlefield, draw a card for each creature you control with a +1/+1 counter on it. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we're gonna go ahead and do 1, 2, 3 for this spell, obviously. And we'll save a blue and potentially more blue. And I'll draw 1, 2, 3. I think with that, we're just gonna go ahead and pass the turn. I'll draw a card for the monarchy here.
I'll just draw naturally. Play an island.
Real natural draw, that one.
Let's see here.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
It's quite a bit of mana.
Yeah.
2 and a black. And we're gonna put a caw-caw! It's a crow of dark tidings. So when it enters the battlefield or dies, I mill 2 cards. So here's 1.
Spark Harvest.
And 2. Phyrexian Rager.
Cool.
I would like to enter the Thrombat. Patrick, I'm going to send the ghost of Ramirez DiPietro at you.
And,
it has menace,
okay.
And it cannot be blocked by creatures with toughness 3 or greater.
Toughness.
So do you have 2 creatures with toughness 3 or greater?
Just the one.
That's correct.
Look at that. Look at you. Wow.
Is good.
Yeah. You may.
Okay.
You may have.
I'll take two. You'll take 2 commander,
and
which is a new
ghost. Water drop, I guess.
Water droplet's good.
Okay.
Cool.
Crazy.
Trigger on Ramirez. It says choose up to 1 target card in a graveyard that was discarded or put there from a library this turn and put that card into its owner's hand. So I will put Spark Harvest into my hand.
Mm-hmm. What is that?
We never triggered this. Sorry.
Oh, wait, that's true.
That's not a man.
Oh, Mander.
I'm sorry. So 1, 2, 3,
not
4,
the crow.
5.
Mm-hmm.
5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have 4.
Mm-hmm.
Take a Mander.
Take a Mander.
Sorry, that needs to happen.
Have a Mander.
Cool.
Continue.
So I have put Spark Harvest in my hand.
Sure.
My hander.
I'd love to see your target for that.
I mean, it's probably the worm. You're the big scary man right now. I don't think Akroma's coming at me.
No. You're not dying. I'm forcing that disc.
Yeah, we got to push the disc forward here. So, I will...
Interesting.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of the manas, and I will just cast this naturally to smash that.
Sure.
And make it dead.
Smash that like button.
End step draw for the monarchy.
He's good.
Off to you.
Natural draw step. Felt supernatural.
Very natural.
Path of Ancestry tapped.
Okay. Just a friendly little land.
If you're just looking for the monarchy, I'm okay to let some damage in.
Do you have a blocker?
Oh,
I have a crow and some other stuff.
He's got some little guys. He's got Amanda.
But if you're just trying to get in there, if you hit me with this guy, I'll let him in.
That's a nice deal.
Where do you want to swing?
Well,
in your perfect world, where would you be swinging?
I mean,
you just took out my big boy.
Yeah,
that was my bomb.
Big boy's out of here. Yeah. I mean, Rebel's pretty frightening.
Yeah.
Here.
I'll kill you if you hit me.
Yeah.
Do if it. You hit me, I'll
do it.
Yeah,
I'll
not really
save you if he tries to kill you. How about that?
This seems good. That's a way to force the disc.
A lot of deals.
It's a good disc forcing situation.
Without the disc.
A disc free
even better.
Save.
A discless save your life.
a discless .com.
Right. Yes. Correct.
If I just haphazardly swing at Rebel.
Yes. You won't have to won't have to deal with that Akroma.
That's
it's a decent trade.
In that case.
I mean, we can keep fighting each other while the man of the nav disc keeps doing his thing.
Yeah,
that's kind of. I'm still on the team of.
I see what you're saying.
Make
Pat.
The disc go.
Yeah, I know you're trying to sweeten things.
I mean, it's like
you
I'm gonna
push
crack
me
it
to
eventually.
Use all my cards to force the disc, so yeah. You don't have to use your cards. So yeah.
It's true. It's true. I will swing one Omen Speaker at you. And see what happens.
Ah, he's activated my trap card, which is a big mander. I feel like we have an understanding here.
Yeah. I mean, it'll carry on. It'll carry on. It'll carry forth. If you wish to...
I will take one. Yeah, we can trade it back and forth. I understand.
I will draw for Monarchy and pass to you.
At the end of your turn, I'll cast a Crushing Vines.
Sure. That's fine.
It is fine. You know what? And I'll even make this green mana to do that.
Whoa.
How about that with the Prophetic Prism?
Just because you can.
Just because I can. And that's it. You may take your turn.
Does Rebel have enough to recast a Chroma? I think she does.
Can you imagine how difficult it is after a Nev's Disc, though? I am so okay with a Chroma recast here, if that's the play. Nev's Disc is a tool not for
Such
collaborating
a tool.
With others. It's
it is a tool.
It depends.
Just the weirdest threat. I don't know why I'm public enemy for this. I've never once touched it or threatened it.
You need to.
The fact that it exists is good enough.
One day. It will pop.
It does hurt me.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Use it while you can. I love that he can exile them, but not save them.
Yep.
This guy? Yeah.
Yeah. That's so good, right? They designed him so well.
Yeah.
Another good white partner.
Excellent white cards.
At the end of turn would have been really interesting.
Yeah.
But yeah, that would have been so much better.
The fact that it has to tap to do it, end of turn would be better.
Yeah.
Mm. Not to, you know, tell anyone how to design a card.
R&D.
This is the most convoluted board state I've ever seen. And all I want to do is make salamanders. That's all I started this game trying to do.
You've done so.
Don't make me disc my own Gorboldrak. Oh. My poor boy.
No man has ever disced
what they
their
did to
own
my boy.
Gore.
4, 5.
Commander's coming
six,
in. The disc is humming.
7, 8, 9. Chroma.
Akroma!
Okay.
Kodama trigger, I'll bring in this angel.
Okay.
Each creature gets +1/+1, and vigilance until end of turn. That's fine. I'll enter combat. These three at you, and this one over at you. At the beginning of combat, each creature gets +1/+1 for each keyword they have. So this has vigilance, so it's +1/+1.
So it's +2/+2, technically. Because of this, right?
+2/+2, technically, yeah.
Yes.
Over here is +1/+1, so 2.
Okay.
Oh, 3 actually, including vigilance.
Well, it's reach and
vigilance.
It
was given vigilance.
Vigilance.
Plus and the +1/+1. Yeah. It gives vigilance and +1/+1.
Sure, sure, sure.
So, same thing, +3.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. He's good.
And over here, +3.
You can exile it, but that doesn't matter. When this dies, you draw a card. That's kind of cute. I think we're just going to block with the Mander here. And I'll block. With the, let's do this. And you can do your thing if you want. I'll probably just wind up taking 8, which I think I can suffer. This game needs to end eventually. I'll block here. That's fine.
Mm-hmm. So only this one goes through?
It's gonna be 7. Yeah.
So how big is this?
That's 8, actually, I think.
Yeah, 8, 7.
That's a 7.
This is a 7-6. 7-6 against your 5-5.
7-6. Against my 5/5.
Yeah.
I'll exile my angel.
Tight.
Back my angel.
Freaking awesome play.
Ooh. And you kill it, right?
Yeah. So
very
we just trade
cool.
here and you take another point.
Yeah.
Down.
That was very cool.
Yeah.
How are you blocking?
I think that this is a 7/6.
Yeah.
It's now bigger.
It's a little bit bigger.
Yes.
Yeah,
so
8/7.
I think we're just gonna mander it up. Just throw a Mander out there.
I had to get rid of the only utility you had, I think.
So this is just a random die, right?
Yeah,
and then this is how many times you've cast your commander?
Exactly.
Commanders.
Zers.
Which passes Monarchy? Did you block?
Sorry, I did block, yeah.
Okay,
so
cool.
Monarchy has not passed.
It is unpassed.
And then you take 9 damage, right?
I already did. Yeah, I already did.
So then I'll pass.
Cards in hand? by the way? Just five.
I have two.
Five cards in hand? Mm-hmm. I don't like that. So on top here, here. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2.
And that's this.
Two. This will stay the way it is. And I got my equipment. That Niv's disc, yeah. That's the thing. I'll draw a card for your turn. What do you think now?
Well, finally.
I want you to waste your hands first. I don't like where you're at relative to me. Yeah but so. I still think I'm in the best position here. Unfortunately, you have plenty of blockers on me. I don't really have a whole host of great options. I think I'm going to go ahead and play an island.
I'm really sad they didn't give this a Chroma Haste.
Oh my gosh, wouldn't that be... That'd be...
Much.
A little
seven
silly.
Mana.
Word soup.
This is drop this, and then, you know, your board gets insane anyway. This is a great combo. That was really cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, too bad I didn't do anything.
I knew it had to happen.
Yeah.
So here's what we're going to do. I think we're going to go ahead and activate the Nev's Disc. We've all been waiting for it. Might as well use the Gift of Paradise while we do so. And in doing so, I'll make 2 green mana. Well, they kept asking for it, and so it shall be. You want me to crack Nev's Disc? I'll do it then. Now, to see the epic conclusion of our Commander Legends draft gameplay, you'll need to stay tuned here on Channel Fireball. Until then, I'm Patrick Marlette, and happy brewing, babies.